Hello everyone, it's Celeste here from Hexen Arcane, and tonight is going to look a little bit different than normal. Normally we intro the movie, we have some skits, we break in a few times. This is a long movie, so we're just going to break in one time, talk briefly about it, but it's such a good movie. I've been really wanting to show it, and it's just something that's, it's been on my list, so I hope you guys really enjoy the movie tonight. We are showing the 1924 Hands of Orlac. This is an Austrian silent film, but I just think it's so masterfully done. It's something that was remade. The storyline has been used for so many things, because when I'm going to give you a brief idea of what the story is, it's going to sound real familiar. Because so many movies have used something similar to this. So there's a pianist who had some kind of accident, and he gets a surgery where his hands are replaced with those of a murderer, and bad things happen. Does that sound like any other movie you've ever watched? Because I bet it does. And that's one of the reasons I really wanted to show this. I think it's an origin of a really interesting plot line that's been used in a lot of things for various reasons. Oh, this person, you know, something or other, brain was replaced with a murderer, all this stuff. So this film was released under the title Die Unheimlichen Hände des Doktor Orlac. So that's the German title if you're curious. And I'm really excited to get into this today and to be able to show it on our show. So I really hope that you guys love this movie and watch it and enjoy it as much as I do. So get to it. I'm back. I really hope that you guys are loving this movie so far. There's just so much about it I love, and I actually have a little bit of trivia for you. There's a few different lengths for it. As you can see, the one tonight is quite long. It almost fills our 2-hour time slot, but it was incomplete for decades. So it took a long time. It was made in 1924. And there was footage that never made it to the American prints, and footage that was cut due to censorship in German prints. And finally, in 1995, this film was restored to its original length. So it took that long to get to the length that you see it today. And there were censorship boards in Germany and Austria that forbade teenagers from seeing this movie when it came out. I'm not really clear on why, but I thought that was pretty interesting. And there was problems with it in Britain too. So there is a scene that the British police complained about, and they claimed that the sequence that shows how you could craft a rubber glove that featured another person's fingerprint could be used by criminals and could stop the progress of police investigations. So they wanted that removed, but it was ultimately cleared and released as normal. It just had a few hiccups. I thought that was interesting because I think a lot of people do get ideas from films. Like, there's a lot of times where there's been true crime cases even where somebody's watched a movie that has inspired them in some way, and which is not to say we should censor media at all, but it's interesting to think about. So on that note, I would like to put you back into the hands of Orlac. Please enjoy more of this interesting, intense, and very cinematic film. It's one of the higher rated films we've shown. Like, as you know, I normally don't like showing the highly rated ones. I like showing the bad ones. But this movie has a special place in my heart, so please enjoy. thank you so much for joining me tonight for this movie. If you made it through it, clap. It's a long movie. It's good, though. It's so good if you could pay attention. Silent films, I know, can be really hard to follow sometimes. They tend to lose a lot of people, especially modern audiences. But there's something so magical about them to me. Like, there's so much that they have to convey just through the acting, and that makes it so superb to me. I think I'm more of a visual person than an auditory person, because I am not the kind of person that could ever tell you, like, what songs are in a soundtrack of a movie, like, pretty much ever. I don't recognize songs, like theme songs, for a lot of people very easily. It's just not something in the way my brain processes it. So silent films actually really appeal to me for that reason. I just really connect with the visuals. And I've been having a beautiful night hanging out in the cemetery with Orlac. And this movie's been remade, I think, like, three times. There have been some good remakes, but I think to me it always comes back to the original and how iconic it was, and the storyline, which was very novel at the time, and the way it was all done. So thank you so much for joining me tonight, and of course we will hex you soon.